Hey guys, so for today's video, we're doing a Throwback Thursday makeup look, and today I used the ColourPop Stone Cold Fox palette to create this eyeshadow look. I love doing these Throwback Thursday videos, and I want to do more of them because it is nice and fun to revisit some older palettes that we might have in our collection. Anyways, before we get started with this makeup look, this video is sponsored by Kenzie. Today I've partnered with them to tell you all about their microdermabrasion handset. So the Kenzie Microdermabrasion Handset is a multifunctional skin cleansing device. So this device exfoliates and suctions away any dead skin cells and other impurities in your skin. So the handset comes in this little box, so let me show you everything you get in here. So first you have the instruction manual, quick start guide, very important. I recommend reading this before you use the product. You get the Kenzie Microdermabrasion Handset, which looks like this, and there are three attachments for it. So first we have the microcrystalline tip, and this tip is the best for deep exfoliation and removing dull, tired skin. And then we have the small tip, which is perfect for smaller areas of your face like the nose and the chin. And this tip is good for extracting blackheads and whiteheads. And then we have the oval tip, which is best for promoting blood circulation. And this tip actually has the strongest suction. And there are four suction levels on this guy. Most people use level 1 or 2 because levels 3 and 4 are meant for like larger parts of your body like the back. So let me show you these. That's 1. That's 2. That's 3 and 4. And also in the box, you get a charging cord and these 5 replacement filters. So personally, I've gotten the actual like microdermabrasion facial done at spas before, and it is really nice because they really do suck away the dead skin cells and kind of cleans out your pores, but it's an expensive service to get done. So when Kenzie asked me if I wanted to try their at-home microdermabrasion handset, I said yes, please. So I've been using this for about 2 months now. So personally, I struggle with clogged pores like all around my nose, especially like right here in the little crevice and just honestly like my entire nose. Also down here on my chin and kind of like the apples of my cheeks. And I've tried using things like extractors and pore strips, but none of them really get like all the gunk out. But this guy actually works for me in cleaning out my pores because it's literally sucking the gunk out of your skin. It sounds so gross, but it's so satisfying. It's non-invasive and doesn't use any chemicals, so it doesn't irritate your skin. But in case you didn't know, microdermabrasion does more than just clean out your pores. It also promotes even skin tone, reduces the appearance of wrinkles and acne scars, and improves the absorption of your skincare products. So now I'm gonna show you guys how I like to use the Kenzie Microdermabrasion Handset. So you wanna use this device on clean skin, and I like to use it just right after my shower because my pores are open and relaxed after a hot shower. You could also steam your face before or just place like a warm towel on top of your face for like 5 to 10 minutes, again, to open and relax your pores. You also wanna make sure you've charged the handset for about 2 hours before your first use. And then for beginners, you should start on the lowest section, but because I've used this product multiple times, I like to use level 2 on my entire face. And I like to use the microcrystalline tip for the larger areas of my face, like my cheek and around my forehead. So when you use this device, you want to use your free hand to pull the skin taut, and you're going to start from the bottom of your face and slowly work your way upwards. So all you got to do is just gently glide the handset along the natural lines of your face. You don't have to apply any pressure, and the stroke should be gentle and swift. At first, it can be kind of tricky to find the right angle where you should hold the device because you do want to keep the suction going along the whole time, but you'll get used to it after a couple strokes. So after I've used the microcrystalline tip along my cheeks and my forehead, I like to switch to the small tip and use that all along my nose. I use it right along the crevices of my nose and just like right on top of my nose as well. And then I will also use a small tip along my chin. So after I've done my entire face, then I just apply my skincare as usual. And like I said earlier, one of the benefits of using this product is that your skincare does absorb more deeply into your skin, so I love that. So your skin does look really nice and glowy and clean after you use the microdermabrasion handset. So if you do want to check out the microdermabrasion handset, you can use my code Angela to save $50. I'll leave a link for the product in the description box, or you can go to kenzie.com, which is kenzzi.com, and then use code Angela to save $50. So I've been using this device about once a week after a shower, and I really do love the results it gives me for my pores. My pores look cleaner and smaller, and I'm definitely going to continue to use this device. So thank you again to Kenzie for sponsoring this part of the video, and now let's get into this makeup tutorial. I'm so excited to dig into this palette today. I know that so many of you guys have this palette and love it so much, so let's do something kind of pretty, shall we? I'm gonna start with Fascinated on a Sigma E35, and I'm gonna run this shade in my crease, and my eye is already primed with a concealer and a translucent setting powder. And I am building up this shade just a couple of times to get it as deep as I want it to be. Now I'm going to take Bold Type on a Sigma E27, and I'm going to start by lightly packing that on the outer half of my lid and then bringing it into my outer crease. Then I'm gonna go back to my fluffy blending brush and just kind of blend over everything to make sure it's nice and seamless. Okay, so now I kind of have gray just like all around my eye, and I wanna put a shimmer on my lid. And honestly, there are so many gorgeous shimmers in this palette, but I definitely wanna do probably a cool toned one, like a gray or a pink, probably not one of the brown ones. So I'm gonna take a Sigma E54 in the shade Baby Doll, and I'm gonna place that on the inner part of my lid. And then I like to take my blending brush and just blend around the edges of the shimmer. I like how subtle that shade is. Now I'm gonna take a Sigma E30 pencil brush and a little bit of the shade Drama Mama, and I'm just gonna add the tiniest bit of that to the very, very outer corner of my eye. I've really been loving doing this step recently with a dark eyeshadow. See how I really just added a tiny bit, but I feel like it makes such a big difference with the shape of my eye. Okay, I am loving how this looks so far. Let's do some face makeup. So recently I've kind of been skipping doing my face makeup on camera just because I kind of do the same thing every day, but I haven't done it in a while, so let's do it together. I did just get this new product from Makeup Geek I wanna try. It's the Skin Brilliance Facial Elixir. And I believe you put this underneath makeup, it makes your skin like nice and glowy. So I'm gonna try it today. Maybe it'll work as like a primer too. I was trying to read the box, and the box doesn't have like any instructions on it. It just has the ingredients. I'm not really sure how this is supposed to be used, but let's try it. Feels really nice and lightweight. Now I'm gonna do a little bit of spot concealing with the NARS Soft Matte Concealer in Light 2 Vanilla. Skin is freaking out a little bit. It's like right before my period, and I'm dealing with a lot of stress right now, which I will go into on a later video. I've been loving this NARS concealer because you only need the tiniest bit to cover like so much. For foundation, I've been loving the Fenty Easy Drop, but I need to buy this in my lighter shade. I only have it in my tan shade. I'm gonna go in with the Bite Beauty Changemaker foundation. This is the shade L25. And I'm gonna use that with the Sigma F85. This has been like my current favorite foundation brush. Then for under my eyes, I'm gonna go in with the Fenty Bright Fix Eye Brightener. I have the shade Melon 06. I've really been loving this product too. I wear it alone a lot, like to the gym. Like that's the only makeup I wear, just to cover any like dark circles. Makes me look a little more awake in the mornings. Then I'm gonna add just a tiny bit of the Tarte Ultra Creamy Shape Tape in Light. Honestly, just like one little dot, nothing too crazy. I'm trying out this sponge from Essence. Honestly, I don't like it. I got it wet and it's like barely even squishy. It's not very soft. Don't recommend. Then I'm gonna set my under eye with some translucent powder. I'm using the RCMA No Color Powder. Okay, Okay, I think I want to do cream blush first before I set my face with powder. So since my eyes are cool toned, I want to wear a cool tone blush. Like you guys know, I've been loving the Melt Honey Thief, but this peach wouldn't look very good with cool toned eyes. So I'm kind of leaning towards this Rare Beauty one in Nearly Neutral. That would look good. Or even with cool tones, you can go just like a little pinker. So even like this would look good together. I might mix these two together. For a cream blush, I've just been loving the Merit brush. I don't know what it's called. It's just the brush from Merit. I'm gonna take the Rare Beauty blush. And I overdid it. I think blush is super important when you're wearing a cool tone look like this, because sometimes you can look kind of dead with like cool tone or gray eyeshadows. And blush really does just kind of bring your face back to life. So make sure you wear blush or just like bronzer if you're wearing cool tones or if you think you look dead. Try more blush. All right, now I'm gonna take my Kosas Cloud Set Powder in Breezy and the Sigma F67 brush. And I'm just gonna set pretty much my entire face. Liking this brush for powder because it has a flat edge to it, so I just kind of press the powder in that way. For a bronzer, I'm gonna use the Fenty Beauty bronzer in Shady Biz and the Sigma F36 tapered cheek brush. I'm gonna bring a lot of this bronzer down my neck because I am pretty pale today. For highlight, I'm gonna take ColourPop Flexitarian. Add a little bit of that to my cheekbones. All right, now let's zoom back in and finish up the eyes. I'm gonna go back to the shade Bold Type on my Sigma E30. I'm gonna place that along my entire lower lash line. I actually like how it looks with just that shade on my lower lash line. Now I'm gonna take a little mix of I Dig It and Dreamful on a Sigma L04. Pop that right in my inner corner. And then I think I'm just gonna do mascara today, no lashes, because I did just get a lash lift, so my lashes are already like nice and big. So for that, I'm gonna use the ColourPop Act Natural Mascara in black. But I am gonna apply my mascara off camera. Go like this and do my mascara because my lashes are so lifted, and if I don't do that, I get mascara all over my lid, so I'll be right back. All right, and here's a full face all done. I did just mascara on my eyes, no lashes, which is kind of weird for me because usually I always wear lashes, especially when I have a full eyeshadow look, but I think it's cute. On my lips, I wanted to do kind of a cool tone pink, so I'm wearing MAC Blinkity with the Fenty Gloss in Fussy on top. I really am loving this palette, and the cool tone shades are just so gorgeous. And again, I want to say thank you to Kenzie for sponsoring this video. Again, if you want to check out the microdermabrasion handset, you can use code Angela to save $50, and I'll leave a link down below for you guys. So I hope you guys enjoy this video. Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe.